Friends, welcome to my channel. Tanish here.
In this video, we will see how to develop a text classification model with multiple outputs. We will be developing a text classification model that analyzes a textual comment and predicts multiple labels associated with the comment. The multi-label classification problem is actually a subset of multiple output model. At the end of this video, you will be able to perform multi-label text classification on your data. The approach explained in this video can be extended to perform general multi-label classification. For instance, you can solve a classification problem where you have an image as input and you want to predict the image category and image description. At this point, it is important to explain the difference between a multi-class classification problem and a multi-label classification. In multi-class classification problem, an instance or a record can belong to one and only one of the multiple output classes. For example, in the sentiment analysis problem, a text review could be either good, bad, or average. It could not be both good and average at the same time. On the other hand, in multi-label classification problems, an instance can have multiple outputs at the same time. For instance, in the text classification problem that we are going to solve in this video, a comment can have multiple tags. These tags include toxic, obscene, insulting, etc. at the same time. The dataset contains comments from Wikipedia's top page edits. There are 6 output labels for each comment: toxic, severe_toxic, obscene, threat, insult, and identity_hate. A comment can belong to all of these categories or a subset of these categories, which makes it a multi-label classification problem. The dataset can be downloaded from this Kaggle link. We will only use the train.csv file that contains 160,000 records. You can download the CSV file in your local directory. Let's now import the required libraries. The dataset is stored in this location. You can see the dataset here. Let me open the dataset. We can see it here. This is the dataset. So it's a huge file. You can see here. So here ID, comment_text, toxic, severe_toxic, obscene, threat, insult, identity_hate. All these columns are. Let's run this. Yeah, it's fine. So the next script displays the shape of the data set, and it also prints the header of the data set. The output. So the dataset contains 159,571 records and 8 columns. The header of the dataset looks like this. Let's remove all records where any row contains a null value or empty string. The comment_text column contains text comments. Let's print a random comment and then see the labels for the comment. the output, it's clearly a toxic comment. Let's see the associated labels with this comment. Let's now plot the comment count for each label. To do so, we will first filter all the label or output columns. You can see that for each epoch, we have values for loss, value loss, accuracy, and value accuracy for all the six dense layers in the output. Let's now evaluate the performance of our model on the test set. An accuracy of 98% is achieved on the test set via multiple output layers. Let's write the script to plot the loss and accuracy values for training and validation sets for the first dense layer. From the output, you can see that the accuracy for test validation set doesn't converge after the first epochs. Also, the difference between training and validation accuracy is very minimal. Therefore, the model starts to overfit after the first epochs, and hence we get an average performance on unseen test set. Multi-label text classification is one of the most common text classification problems. In this video, we understood two deep learning approaches for multi-label text classification. In the first approach, we used a single dense output layer with multiple neurons, where each neuron represented one label. In the second approach, we created separate dense layers for each label with one neuron. Results show that in our case, single output layer with multiple neurons work better than multiple output layers. As a next step, I would suggest you to change the activation function and train the test split to see if you can get better results than we got now.
Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks a lot.